What is up, everybody? Championship week is here. Billy Hall, Paul Honda, I mean Cam Newton. I hate that jersey, but anyway.
Second
Paul
time Honda, I've worn it.
Paul Honda here.
I don't like the Superman stuff, but...
And the dancing?
Undefeated.
No.
But we'll, I don't know.
But that's the NFL. We're here to talk about high school. I think this is going to be our last video together.
Ever.
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 Until next year.
I'm so happy.
But we got two big games. Friday night, we got D1, D2 championship games. Kahuku, St. Louis. Everyone's talking about it. Taking us back to the late 90s, early 2000s, and some of those classic matchups.
To before these kids were, most of them were born, pretty much.
Yeah, just little babies. But
toddlers.
But no, really exciting game. You got Kahuku, the undefeated team, but you got St. Louis is the number one ranked team in our poll. People think, seem to be on the side of St. Louis winning this game. Ultimately, where this game comes down to, what's going to make or break this game, do you feel like, for either team?
Simplicity.
Simplicity.
If you can keep your thing simple and move the chains, somebody's going to make a mistake eventually. It's high school football. Yeah. NFL, they make mistakes. So somebody's going to, and that's what Koku's banking on, I think. They don't want to get into too much of a trips, shotguns. Cameron Renault, for a guy who's hardly been on the field, is really good.
Yeah.
He's sharp.
Yeah.
Well trained. John Howell. Offensive coordinator, excellent job.
Genius.
But if they can just run their double tight end, no wide receiver, double fullback, H-back, 2,500 pounds coming at you every play, and win that way, I think Vavai Tata, their coach, will take it.
Yeah. You know, I find it really interesting because St. Louis looks so good in that second quarter against Milani that everyone just kind of is like, wow, what an amazing show. How are they going to lose? But when we were kind of doing, we were looking up all the old Cuckoo St. Louis matches, and the one that kind of stuck out to me was the 1999 state final. It was the first championship game. St. Louis, I think, was averaging 50-something points. They had Timmy Chang. They had Gerald Wells. They had Fiaseu at running back. They had just dominated through everybody. Kugel held them to 19 points.
Yep.
And that was surprising. And the only thing about that game was Kugel lost 19-0. They couldn't score. So, for me, I don't expect St. Louis to go throwing it around, putting up big yards, and scoring a ton of points. But if Kuku slows him down and holds him to 20 points, can Kuku score 20 points?
Well, look, I think in the late 90s, that was St. Louis dynasty to the max, right?
Yeah.
Kids coming in from all over the island. St. Louis was the destination. A magnet school, Cal Lee, Ron Lee, that whole staff, sending kids like Jason Gesser to Pac-12 schools. I mean, they were at their peak.
Yeah.
St. Louis right now is close to that, but it's been only 2 years since Cal came back.
That's true. That's true.
I don't think they are what they were back then right now. It could easily happen by next year, I think.
Yeah. Yeah, I think next
year. They got numbers, many more numbers than before, like last year and the year before, before Cal came back. I think Kahuku has a chance because physically they can match up.
Yeah. Oh, definitely.
They can take a hit. St. Louis is playing physical football. Yeah. Borderline, I'll hit you right after the whistle or right before, but I'm going to hit you.
Yeah, you know what's coming.
Kahuku can take it. The lightest guy on their offense is Harmon Brown, and he's pretty he's pretty stout, 180. Everybody else is 210. 280, 290, 300, they're going to withstand that physicality. So that doesn't mean they're going to win just on size, but execution, simplicity, Kesi Ahoy, taking care of the ball, punt.
Yeah.
Punt, 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 move the ball, field position, Kekoa Sasaoka, a couple of field goals, it changes the whole game now. The pressure will be on Tua, Tagovailoa, and that offense to take care of the ball too, because they know if they give up the ball, Kahuku might take the ball and keep it for 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes.
Pound away on that defense. Pound away on
and
that defense.
And it's happened before where a high scoring team kind of gets out of rhythm because they're sitting on June Jones, right? At UH. He didn't want Kevin Lempa, running a Bamba don't break defense. He wanted the ball back.
Yeah.
Get a sack, get a turnover, but don't let that other team stay out there 7, 8 minutes.
Yeah. And for Kahuku, Tua is not going to have the time he had last week against Milani, but you cannot give him time back there for Kahuku. You've got to get to him quick.
I think they'll mix up the blitz. They'll bring Herky Latu. But I think Kahuku's willing to let they've done this before where they give you some cushion. You get down to the 20. Now they lock down.
Yeah.
And that's where they do most of their damage touchdowns, with the turnovers. Kiala Santiago, Keikala Kaniho, and all these guys. They got sticky fingers.
Yeah. A chance for Kahuku to complete that undefeated season. A chance for St. Louis. You think out those first three Cal Lee games, to go from those three big losses to winning the state championship next year would be pretty impressive. So a lot of people are going to be there Friday night. It's going to be fun. Division two, we got to talk about too, though. Radford Kapaa. This Kapaa defense has been next to impossible to score on by any Division two team. Radford, all of a sudden, went crazy on offense last week. You saw that game. How much tougher, though? I imagine Radford's going to have kind of a little bit of a more difficult time scoring on Kapaa.
I think this. Look, Kapaa, they played some pretty good teams. Kauai football is always good. They had some tough preseason games. They played Lahaina a little. They haven't really been pushed to the point where they had to expand. Radford's been pushed. Kona-Wana came in with that hurry-up offense was the quickest I've seen since Mililani midseason. And then when Milton came back, when McKenzie came back, they were at that tempo again. Radford's now been through that.
Yeah.
And they don't normally give up 46 points, but they did it. They played better in the second half. Now they know, okay, our offense can carry us sometimes.
Yeah.
Kapaa hasn't quite been there yet, but talent-wise, they're there with Radford. Mm-hmm. There's no question. So, you know, they like to run the ball out of that spread. Radford, it's going to be interesting if they can keep their linebackers on the field, right? They got the stud linebackers, Jordan Walker and all these. Can they get out there and cover slots without having to change personnel? Because you know Kapaa would rather run it.
Yeah.
So this could end up being like 10-7, 7-0.
Well, and you know it's a big trip.
3-2.
Yeah, it's a big trip for those Kauai teams coming over here. Because remember, Kauai came over here, what was it, 2-3 years ago against Kaiser? Gave them a great game in the D2 title game.
Underrated league.
Yeah.
Yeah, underrated league.
Should be fun. D1, D2 state titles Friday night. Paul Honda, for the last time, thanks for doing this. I'll see you next year.
I miss you, Billy.
Thanks a lot.
He's the bone crusher.
WhitePrepWorld.com, StarAdvertiser.com.